creating video content and you need to get better at video editing, here's the good news. Canva is easier than ever to edit your videos. So in this video, I'm gonna share with you a little bit behind the scenes, super easy ideas, techniques, and tips for how you can edit video right within Canva. Let's go.
Let's get into video editing with Canva. So I'm on canva.com on my desktop. Now you can do this also on your phone, but I find for longer form videos, if it's not a reel or TikTok, if you're doing longer form videos like for YouTube or Facebook, I tend to usually like to do it on my computer. So I'm gonna go to canva.com and in the upper right-hand corner, there's a button for create design. I'm gonna click that. I'm gonna search video. So I'm gonna click video and that's gonna open up the blank template or blank screen right here. Now you might have your video that you've already created on your phone, and this is where the Canva app comes into play. So if you have a video on your phone, you can upload it into the Canva app and then go on to canva.com on your computer and access that video really easily, which is kind of cool. And for the focus of this video, I'm just sharing a few quick video editing tips. So this idea is you've got a video and you just want to enhance it just a little bit. And I'll be honest with you, I always say done is better than perfect. Keep it simple. I think for a lot of us, we don't need a lot of the fancy video edits, but there's a couple simple things that Canva makes it really easy to do. So I'm here on this blank screen on the left-hand side, by the way, there's a lot of templates. We're gonna skip that for right now. And I'm going to go over to this uploads button. Now this is where you can actually record a video. So if you don't have a video recording, you can simply hit record and it's really easy to do. I've recorded a lot of videos right within Canva, which is awesome. You just hit record, it'll record it. You can do a number of takes, however many times you'd like, and then you're good to go. So we're gonna exit out of that and just go right to videos, because once you have created a video or uploaded videos, they're all going to be right here. So for the sake of this example, I'm gonna go down and pull in this example. I'm just gonna click on it. And as I click on it, you can see it doesn't show up full screen. So what you can do is just drag the corners until it gets full screen right there. And then it'll fill up the full screen. Now, a couple simple video editing things that you can do that I really like, and actually I'm gonna adjust it so make it fit that screen right there, is you can trim the first few seconds and the last few seconds. A lot of times when we record video, we take this pause. We look down, we make sure it's recording, and then we start talking. And we do the same thing at the end. Look down, we hit stop. And that little thing can really distract people and get people to not watch your video. So as silly as it sounds, if you do anything, just trimming out that little pause in the beginning and pause at the end can make a big difference. So you can see in the beginning, I'm looking down. What you do is you're gonna go over to the left-hand side and I'm just gonna drag this little slider right here until I look up. So you can see I'm looking down and then I'm gonna drag it to when I look up. So then I can hit play and it's gonna play. I'm gonna go all the way to the end of the video. So you can see I'm gonna do the same thing at the end. And it's gonna go all the way to the end. And then I'm gonna show you what this looks like. So I'm gonna hit pause one more time. At the very end, I'm gonna click on it. And again, you can see how I look down. And I'm gonna trim it all the way until I look up. Again, it's like half a second, but it's that little thing that can make a big difference. Now, if that's all the video editing you do, that's awesome. If you're like, so simple, one and done, easy, you would name your video, whatever your video is, maybe real estate, market update for 2023, just making something up. Then you would click share, and then you would download that to your computer, and then you would upload it on YouTube, Facebook, or wherever you want to upload it, okay? Now, if you wanna do some additional things, there's a couple things that I think are really easy to do. You can add your name. So if you wanna add your name or any text over the file, I'm going to actually go back to the beginning here, and I'm gonna click the text button on the left-hand side, and I'm gonna click add text box, and it's automatically gonna be very small, so let's make this larger so we can read it. And then you can add in text. So you might wanna add in your name, maybe you wanna add in your name and title. If you are required by your local association to write in your DRE number, this is also a nice place to do this as well. So I'm just gonna put social media strategist as my title, but you would have a realtor or whatever your title is. I'm gonna stretch that out. And then at the top, there's a little menu. So I'm gonna change it to left, kind of left alignment right there. And then if you wanted to kind of make it stand out, you can go over to effects on the top and there's all these different effects. So one of the ones I use a lot is lift. It tends to just make your text pop a little bit, which is kind of nice. So I'm gonna use that, or you can use shadow, which kind of just, again, makes it pop. Now, one thing that's actually fairly new with Canva with this text is you can see the text box here and there's a couple different options. I can duplicate that text if I wanted. I could delete it if I didn't like it. But if you click these three little dots, it's going to show a button that says show timing, which is really cool. So I can click show timing. And this purple bar is how long that text is on the screen. So if you want it on the screen the whole time, that's fine. You can certainly do that. But maybe you only want the text on the screen for part of your video. So I'm going to kind of move it around here. I'm going to move this over and just kind of finagle it around a little bit. I'm just kind of dragging it around. You can see that purple text box is getting a little bit smaller. And so maybe you just want it in the very beginning. So you have your title, then you have your video, and then maybe at the end, you want some sort of call to action at the end, right? So you get through your video and you go all the way to the end, and you have some sort of call to action at the end that you can add also. So for example, I could click text again, add a text box, and maybe that's something like, contact me for more information, right? Or you could put subscribe to our channel, right? This is great, especially if you're doing a video on YouTube. So with that, again, I'm going to click on that. Obviously, I don't want it to just live like right in the middle there, but I'm going to click show timing. And that way I can have that at the very, very end. Let's just put this maybe in the last like 10 seconds, 5 seconds or so. And then again, I can move that over to wherever I like it. So I'm going to adjust that a little bit right there. Just at the very end. So you can really kind of get creative with this. This is kind of nice, especially if you are, and you'll see them overlap, but they're actually not overlapping when you play it. It's only going to appear wherever that purple text box is. So this is really helpful if you're doing a video about a listing and maybe you want to have, you know, something where it says kitchen, bathroom, living room, you want text over the screen, you can add multiple types of text, which is kind of cool. The other thing that you can do, which is kind of fun, is you can go over to elements and click on elements. There's all different types of elements. The most common ones probably for real estate are like house or home or keys. I'm just going to search the word house. And under graphics, there's lots of different graphics. I do have a pro account with Canva, but what you're doing with all the options I'm talking about here today, most of them are available in the free version. So, you know, if you wanted to have a little house icon, I could do that. I could kind of adjust that. I could go up to the color. I don't really like black because it's hard to see. I'm going to click on that and change it to white. So if you wanted a little icon, you could do that also. And then the other thing that's really nice, I'll share one other quick tip with video editing, is you can add photos. So if you're doing a listing about your community or about your local market or about a listing, under uploads, under images, you're going to want to upload some supporting images. So if you have a video about your favorite things about a local community or maybe about a listing, upload those and then you can add some of those photos to your video. So if I've got a listing, I might add, you know, a photo maybe in the corner talking about, you know, that part of the listing, right? Now, alternatively, I can also click on the video itself and make it a little smaller if I wanted to make it smaller, there's a lot of different things you can do. Again, I'm all about kind of keeping it simple, which I think is key. So you can have photos kind of appear and disappear, which is nice if you're saying, oh, in the living room, blah, blah, blah. And you can have those appear and disappear. And then you would just set the time. So for each image that you add, you would want to show that timing to wherever you want it to be. So if you wanted that to appear, at this point in your video, you could do that. And at any point, if you wanted to delete it, you can just click on it and delete it. So I would say, honestly, the easiest editing to do is where you're trimming the beginning and the end. Again, you can record right within Canva, which is great. You can upload your videos. And again, you can adjust that timing, which makes it really, really simple. So, again, like I said, at the end of the day, done is better than perfect. Play around with it, try it out, and let me know what you think. All right, there we go.
Okay, I would love to hear from you. Have you been using Canva and are you using it for video editing? Let me know in the comments below. If this has been helpful, we would absolutely love for you to hit the subscribe button and the bell button as we have new videos that come out each and every week. And if you need a little guidance with Canva, good news, go to katielance.com/Canva. I've got a checklist. I've got a free checklist. If you've been here for any period of time, you know we love a good free checklist. It's going to be chock full of helpful tools, tips, and ideas, not just with video editing for Canva, but for other tips with Canva. So go to katielance.com/Canva and check it out. We'll see you soon. Bye for now.